Are you ready to listen to a podcast?
Here comes the Playhouse Podcast. Thanks to Bradshaw and Brian Law Offices.
Find, subscribe, and listen.
God, I felt so bad the other day. Drop Liam off for baseball. I'm like, I have a good 60 solid minutes. I'm going to go gas up. I'm going to go clean my car. And I'm going to vacuum. And there's this place that you could do it yourself in town. And I'm vacuuming. I'm almost done. But my whole body is in trying to get the back vacuumed. And then I hear behind me this booming song. And it wasn't this. I can't identify what 80s song it was.
But it felt like this.
What it felt like.
So, so middle-aged dude with a classic car.
Look behind me, and he was putting his 75 cents in. And I look, and I'm like, oh, my God, it's him again. Last time I saw him, it was at Subway. And Liam, I had to hold his head in place
so he
wouldn't
stare.
Look at him anymore because he has this massive wig on. And it's not even subtle. It's not subtle whatsoever. And it's just like Joe Dirt. Unsubtle. It's crazy. And I did like a, not a gasp. I didn't like grab my pearls or anything, but I was like, you know, and I don't know how to handle those situations because I'm around so many bald people. It's crazy. And I just think if you're going that way, just embrace it. I don't think there's anything wrong with that.
There's a generational gap. There's a generational gap between how old I am and how old the next generation is. They're not okay with being bald.
I think he's maybe only a few years older than you.
It's baldness was looked at as like a weakness almost. And I remember when I shaved my head. And then I came back, and my dad thought I was in a cult. I came back from college, and I had shaved my head.
Yeah.
And then I told him, I go, hey, that's because I have too much testosterone. I think you want to back off, old man. And and my dad was a Green Beret, and at that moment, I remember him just taking a couple of steps towards me. And I go, no, I'm just kidding, man.
I'm just kidding.
But I tried to explain the science to him, but his generation still looked at it as,
I know,
it just means you're getting old. It just means you're not the man you need to be.
But in this guy's head, I feel like he's legit living in the 80s. There's something charming about it, but then there's also a
part
of me that's
charming,
like,
about a bad wig.
Well, just like the fact that he is for sure living still that life, like where everything should cost like change.
One of my first radio jobs, I worked with a guy that had a really bad wig, and this guy, he was a larger dude, didn't really take care of his body too much. So because of that, he had he stunk.
Oh, no.
He had bad BO, but he always had the sweat rings on his shirt, you know, like through the shirt. But then in an intense situation, and I remember he had to come in and yell at me for something I did on the air once, but he was not very confrontational.
Yeah.
And he came into the studio and asked if I had a couple of minutes, and he tried to be polite, but he had sweat beads rolling out from under his wig.
Oh, no.
Like down the side of his temple.
Yeah.
And I go, Mark, what's going on? You're sweating. Well, I need to talk to Bo what you did on the show last night.
Yeah.
And I go, well, it's that bad that you're sweating? Do you want me to open the window in here or whatever? But he would constantly have the sweat beads roll out from under his wig.
Yeah. Laura already texted that they had to have an intervention with her dad 4 years ago because his wigs kept getting worse and worse. And then they finally convinced him to ditch the wig and go full bald. It's the style.
It's freeing, guys. I'm telling you.
I just want to let you know, like, don't be a topic on my show. Radio paparazzi. So I'm hot off a Justin Bieber concert. And I told Derek, I'm like, it had kind of a youth church retreat feel because there's a lot of mention of God.
It's his lifestyle now.
It is his lifestyle. And it wasn't pushy. Don't get me wrong. It wasn't like, you're here and you will listen and agree with everything I have to say. He was just like...
Chance the Rapper was that way, too. My son, we were in a suite through a bunch of other people at a Chance the Rapper show.
Yeah.
And his was all about praise up. You know what I mean? But it wasn't pushy. It wasn't like, hey, I need you to sign up for this church event or whatever. It was just, that was part of his persona.
Yeah, his vibe now very calm. And he tried to keep the audience calm despite what was happening just right down the road from where his Buffalo, New York show was, where the man gunned down at least 13 people, 10 died. And so here's what he said.
You guys probably heard what happened. Pretty horrible stuff. But I'm looking forward to tonight, looking forward to getting on that stage and doing what we do best and having a good time and bringing joy to the city.
You know, as we know, there's been tragedy in the city, but what we're going to do tonight is we're going to honor those people. And I would love if we could just take a moment of silence. That would mean a lot to me. So we can start right now.
There you go. It's kind of like an homage. Jason Momoa, he got in a little bit of trouble. He posted a video over the weekend apologizing for taking pictures inside the Sistine Chapel, which he was told not to.
If you ever thought that I disrespected your culture, it wasn't my intention. I always wanted to, you know, now that I can, gave a wonderful donation to bring my friends and crew to go experience these places. And then I found people really wanted to take pictures with me. And so I was very respectful and I asked for permission from what I thought would be okay.
Right. And he basically was told, go ahead, but it wasn't the right authorities that said it.
The Billboard Music Awards were on last night. Not sure if you knew.
I didn't even hear about it
uneventful.
Until this morning.
Derek yelled up because sometimes we'll watch like the MTV Video Music Awards with Liam because he loves music, you know, and he gets to see his favorite like KCLD artist perform or whatever. And I just said, I'm not a big Diddy fan. And I feel like Diddy would
host it?
Yes.
Oh.
And he was just, I don't know, he was Diddy, you know. But Machine Gun Kelly was like the standout because he alluded to the fact that maybe he was married.
I wrote this song for my wife.
Oh, wait, what?
And this is for our unborn child.
What?
Do we know that she's pregnant?
No.
Do we know that they're married?
Nobody knows if any of that is true or if he's just trying to hype up something or trying to beat Courtney and Travis, who, in fact, over the weekend in Santa Barbara, did officially tie the knot. So they are married.
Two things.
Officially. Yeah.
I'm not doing Kravis. You'll never hear me say Kravis. Number two.
I got Kravis last
night. His name was Larry. So I'm not doing Kravis. And then the other thing is, if they're not married and she's not pregnant, this dude's a genius. We're all talking about it this morning.
No doubt.
Good
it's
for
all
you, Machine Gun Kelly.
Yep, he knows what he's doing. Speaking of Machine Gun Kelly, Megan Fox, it's her birthday today, 36. Tori Spelling is 49, and I love him. Danny Trejo is 78 today.
All right, it's Katie with a Y, by the way. And when she hit us up last week and said, guys, I'd like your opinion on this.
Which, if you ever have anything you want to bring to the radio, like we say, we won't mention your name. We don't have to mention specifics. But, I mean, if you're curious as to how to handle a situation like this one,
and
let us know.
Use a headline like, should I date the kid I babysit?
Don't use the word kid. I don't know if we can legally do that.
We will immediately open that up. Now, I know it's not really like that, Katie, but can you break this down for everybody else?
All right. I was just wondering if it's like ethical to date or hook up with someone that you babysat.
Sure.
Like, not now. Like, I'm not babysitting this person
he's
now.
He's like an adult now.
Yeah, he's an adult now.
Okay.
Like, I babysat him when he was 11.
Okay.
And it was more for his sister who was 4 at the time, and I was 18. And I haven't seen him in a while, but I saw him at the bar last weekend, and he's 22 now.
Yeah.
And
go for this.
Hot.
Stop it.
Absolutely go for this.
Man.
Now, he's a consenting adult, and so are you. You absolutely go for this.
But you gave him care when he was 11. I don't know if I could get over that hump of, like, thinking about that.
Three drinks gets you over that hump, I'm telling you.
And you said he seems interested?
Yeah, he seemed interested, and if you saw him, I don't know that you would have an issue. He's like Chris Hemsworth hot.
Yeah, you gotta do this, and then you gotta call us back and let it know how good it was.
Why are you so excited?
This is one of those you read about kind of scenarios that never happens because it was always maybe it could have, and people talk him out of it. I think you go for this.
I don't know. That is a good question. Is there something ethically wrong with this? I honestly don't know if I could get over that mental picture of him being 11, but did you take a picture? Maybe you could text it to us. And two, yeah, I'm going to need an update. All right?
Sounds good. I'll text you a picture. Good. How are you?
Good. Thanks for calling the show. We appreciate it. We're just kind of taking opinions on the caller we had a couple of seconds ago. Her name is Katie, and she used to babysit this kid 11 years ago. And she just saw him at the bar, and she's like, he's smoking hot. Did she say he's Chris Hemsworth hot?
Looking prime. We got a photo during that song, and he is very good looking. But still, in my mind, I don't know if I could get a hold of that, you know, now I lust after him situation. Would you?
Honestly, yes. I have married my best friend's oldest brother. Okay. I have known him since I was 9 years old, and he was 18 at the time.
Oh, wow. So you guys have a lot of, like, back-in-the-day stories, or are you making new memories as adults, or is it there's no awkwardness?
No, no awkwardness at all, and it's both.
How many people in the town you grew up in? This has to be a small town thing.
We were in Brainerd.
Oh, okay. Well, Brainerd's not a small town.
Well, yeah, not super huge, but also not tiny.
Were your families close, or was it just you and the best friend?
Nope, just me and the best friend.
That's so weird. It's so weird that you were 9 years old, and then you were 10, and you were 11, and he was going away to get a job or go to college, and then later on down the line, you guys end up hooking up and getting married.
Did you ever have any pillow talk where he admitted that he had a thing for you a long time ago?
When you were 9?
Yeah. Oh, God, no.
Yes.
Never mind. Don't answer that. Don't answer that. That's weird.
I mean, does that ever come up? Is he like, oh, when you turned 13, Alana, I was really, really hoping you'd still come see my sister.
Yuck.
You know, we have talked about it, but really the biggest thing was as I grew up, we did grow closer, and he helped me through a lot of issues that I had had growing up with my family, and he saw how I had matured and grown into such a different woman when... Sure. Compared to when I was 9. And we just...
So this wasn't a lusty
other.
Sexual thing. It was, he was just like, he was very helpful. He was a good human being and was kind of there for you when you needed it.
Yes.
Wow.
All right.
It's very, it doesn't make for a good romance novel, but it makes for a good life story.
So you're kind of on Kate's side. You say go for it. I mean, he's 22. He's well over the legal age. So.
Yeah, I absolutely say go for it. I mean, my husband, when I was 10, he actually had a baby, and he it was completely not planned or anything, and he proposed to the woman to try to be a good person and do the right thing, and it didn't work out, but... I have a great stepdaughter because of it, and an amazing husband.
So your stepdaughter's
only...
I think
she should do it.
10 years younger than you are.
That's correct.
Right. Well, I mean, we're making it sound crazy, but, I mean, it happens in Hollywood all the time.
So. Hey, Alana, then I have a quick question. So how old is your stepdaughter now, then?
14.
Can you put yourself in her shoes and go, hey, she has a friend who's got a 21-year-old... brother, do you think they're giving each other the googly eyes? Do you ever think that way?
No.
Not till now.
She's a very different kind of girl.
Yeah.
She's really not into any romance or anything like that.
Oh, it'll happen.
Keep it that way.
It'll happen.
All right. Well, thanks for calling.
Great story. Thanks for helping us out. Have a great day.
Yeah, you too.
3857 says it sounds like grooming. LOL.
So what does that mean? What does that mean?
That means as an older person, you know what you want, but you almost trick the person that's way younger than you.
Oh, that's a thing.
Grooming? Absolutely. Groom people to be sex servants. Like, that's the whole, like, underground sex world with younger kids. It's horrible.
How do you know so much about this, Kat?
Because on the bathroom stalls at Quick Trips. You have to call if you see something.
And it's called grooming.
Yes. I mean, it's serious stuff.
I'm living a pretty sheltered life.
Yeah, you
here.
Are. Go to the bathroom more. A video is going viral on TikTok, and I think all parents need to listen up if you have kids that need to learn how to protect themselves in case somebody tries to take them. Here we go.
If somebody tries to kidnap them or pull them away from their family, don't just scream. I need them to yell out every single curse word they could possibly think of. If you're at a playground or something like that and you hear a child scream, that's not really alarming to you. But if you hear a child yelling out every single curse word, you're going to stop mid-conversation and say, hold on, and look to see what's going on with this child. Why is this child cursing like that?
It actually makes pretty good sense.
It does. Can you imagine hearing a four-year-old voice say the F-bomb and then you're like, what? Wait, I don't think that they're in a good position. So if you feel like that's the route you want to go ahead.
Practice in church.
Yeah, right.
Get some practice in here, guys.
Okay, so today it's a big day. I'm excited for dinner tonight.
Fire up the grill.
Wait a minute. I smell barbecue.
Someone's grilling meat.
Barbecue?
Barbecue.
Did someone say barbecue?
Barbecue.
Today is National Barbecue Day.
What is that? Barbecue? Pork barbecue.
Pork, beef, or chicken.
I love barbecue. Barbecue.
Happy National Barbecue Day.
I'll fire up the grill.
I do the grilling.
Showtime.
There you go. I just got a new wood board from Salmon. I'm excited. Salmon is one of my favorite things to make on the grill because it is so fast, so easy. And then you roast some garlic in like some tin foil. Have you ever done that? Like a big clove of garlic?
I've done that, yeah.
Oh, yes. So go ahead and throw something on the grill and celebrate Happy National Barbecue Day.
It's Secret Sound Talk with St. Cloud Toyota and 104.7 KCLD.
Now, what would be awesome on a bonus day is for a guy like Mark to just stroll in here and win $2,000 as caller number 10. Now, we mentioned when we picked up Mark and told you were caller 10, you were dropping your son off at school. What's the plan for the rest of the day?
I'm just going to try to get the rest of my deck done today.
Oh, so you're working outside on the deck now. Are you doing this by yourself? Like, do you have that skill set or is somebody else like doing most of it and you're just kind of helping?
No, we're just winging it. Just me, my wife, and my son.
Wow, that's inspirational because I have enough skills to replace deck boards. But if it came to, like, I would trust my family standing on something for an increased amount of time, I can't do that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what are you saying? You're better than me? Is that what you're saying?
No.
Let's get you this money, man. $2,000 still in the Secret Sound jackpot. A bonus day. And this will be the last day we play. So listen close. Here is your Secret Sound, Mark. So I ask you for $2,000. Mark, what's the secret sound?
I'm going to guess that it is a fan turned on, like the blades of a fan.
So, like, turning a fan on and off.
Yes.
Okay.
Or having the fan run.
What would give you that impression?
Just by the clues and the video that you showed.
Is this turning a fan on and off a whole bunch of times? And did Mark just win $2,000? First, the sound one more time, guys. Is that worth $2,000? Yes! Oh, my God! That's it!
Oh, my God!
That's it, dude!
I didn't even know it. I just found out with you.
That is worth $2,000, Mark! I need to set the mood first.
Roll another...
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
I know you're not a fan of smoking the hoobie.
I don't care if other people do. It's not a big deal for me.
To have it not be nationwide legal to me is a little bit stupid. But as more states continue to legalize recreational marijuana, it's much more part of our open culture than it probably ever has, and it will continue to be. I would have said probably 5 years ago that it'd be legal across the entire northern hemisphere by now, but it's not. So I wanted to dig into how much you really know about certain strains of the Mary Jane.
All right, so is this either pot or like a plant? So we can call it Kush or Bush.
It's you could call
right?
it that.
Okay.
Basically, I just need you to know, or need you to tell me whether or not it's real or fake. I will name a marijuana, a type of strain, and you tell me whether I made that up or it's actually real.
This is going to be so hard because they have funny, crazy names, and there are thousands and thousands of them.
Real or fake?
All right.
Chronic the Hedgehog.
I'm going to say that is real. No, a pothead wasn't sitting there on his weird couch and just said, oh, my God.
Chronic the Hedgehog.
Chronic the Hedgehog is going to be so funny.
Giggle Smoke.
Yes. Okay. I feel like I'm just going to say yes to all of them.
Pippi Bong Stocking.
I'm going to say no.
You're right. That's right. That's fake.
That's a funny one, though. See? They're getting ideas.
The Chris Hempsworth.
Yes. And it's got to make everyone look really good. No?
It's fake.
Oh, that's a funny one, too.
Earwax. Is that fake or real?
That's got to be real.
It is real.
Yeah. It looks like something that came out of an ear.
I can't believe it's not Buddha. Is that real or fake?
I'm going to say fake.
Correct. Well done. That is fake. Grassoline. Grassoline. Is that real or fake?
I'm going to say that is fake.
Grassoline is a real type of marijuana, Kat.
All right.
Real or fake? Catnip.
I'm going to say real.
All right, I got two more.
Okay.
See if you can run the table. Real or fake strain of marijuana, Kat? Skunk in the trunk.
That is fake.
Right. Good job. And our last one. Skunk in the trunk.
Again?
I was just going to see if you were high right there, so I repeated it. So always leaving voicemails.
Yep.
No matter the situation. Hey, it's just me. Thought I'd call, leave you a voicemail. Bye.
So my dad will, you've seen him skip the vowels because he thinks he pays per letter, for texting. And so it's like C-L-M-S-N, call me soon.
Oh, you know? That's not climbing snow.
But if he leaves me a voicemail, it's like 7 seconds long. I'm like, what could he say in 7 seconds? And it's always 5 seconds of just like, white noise. And then he goes, call me back. It's crazy.
Boomers are obsessed with zooming in on every single picture and also filming with iPads.
Yeah.
If you go to your kid's basketball game, baseball game, whatever it is, dance recital.
Yeah.
If you're four rows behind a grandparent, they got that iPad way up there filming the whole thing.
It's very true. Very, very true.
Boomers are obsessed with complaining about younger generations not knowing or using cursive.
I love cursive, and you always give me crap that I think they should teach it in schools.
No.
It's beautiful.
Stop this madness.
Oh, it's so distinguished and refined. I love it.
And here's where the number one thing, by the way, that boomers are obsessed with. And I thought I was hip and fly when this list came out and that I was going to avoid being called a boomer the rest of my life. But the number one thing that boomers are obsessed with, using the thumbs up emoji.
Oh, yeah. But I send it 8 times a day.
That's all I do.
All right. I'm a boomer
then. All I do is use that damn emoji.
I'll embrace it.
I've been using praise up a lot lately.
You bless up.
And and the bicep one.
For who?
Yeah, for anybody. People just text me. I go, perfect, bicep.
So you're trying to strong arm texting?
Just trying to make it look like I'm a little tougher than I am in my old age.
Oh, strange.
So if one of those things is impeding your life right now.
Paparazzi. Oh, my heart dropped for her this weekend. Found out that Britney Spears sadly lost her baby.
Spears posting to Instagram in a joint post with Sam Asghari that they suffered a miscarriage. The 40-year-old pop superstar first announced back in April they were expecting a child. She wrote it in today's post. They will continue trying to expand their family and are asking for privacy during this difficult time.
I've never had a miscarriage, luckily. There are too many women that have dealt with that sometimes time and time again. But I do know that when I found out, even just the hours after that I was pregnant, all you do is constantly think about a living being and how to make their life amazing. And so I can't even imagine what she is going through. And I really, really hope that they can get lucky sometime.
I think we can all agree that she's mentally been fragile over the last few years.
Yeah.
And that's why I think the concern is so high. And it's going to be good that she seems like she's got a pretty good guy by her side, but that support system is going to be needed.
Absolutely. I hope she has somebody to talk to, like aside from him, that she can just explode her feelings and they can help her through it.
She's been forced on therapists for so long.
They've been bad therapists, though. These have been hired by her dad. Like, she needs a really good one. Ariana Grande says that she has not begun work on new music, sadly.
The truth is, I have not begun an album. That was kind of around the time that I started hearing murmurs about a
Wicked audition. The most incredible gift of my entire life is this role that I've adored since I'm 10 years old. And that is going to have every piece of me, every minute, every ounce of my heart, my time, my soul, my everything that I can give it.
I appreciate that. I can respect the fact that she's putting her all into that project.
Oh, my God. It's going to sell out. It's going to be months and months of nonstop sold out shows for Wicked on Broadway. That is very exciting. And also the film version for her. Bobby Brown, his now wife, Alicia. This is a crazy story. She talked him out of his pre-wedding jitters to Whitney Houston all the way back then.
By then, all of his groomsmen and his brother could not get him out the bathroom. So I was like, listen, we are getting this show on the road. You know, we're here and this is happening. And I was talking to him through the door, and then finally he like peeked it a little bit and I got in, you know, and it was like, let me in, let me in. Everything's going to be okay. And for some reason, you know, he listens to me. and he eventually came out the bathroom and went down that aisle.
So let me get this right. He's currently married to the woman that talked him into marrying somebody else.
Right. Isn't that crazy how life does that about face? And they're like, nope, this is actually who you were supposed to be with. Blowing out their candles today, Megan Fox is 36. Tori Spelling is 49. David Boreanaz is 53. And I have no idea how he made it to 49, but Wee Man from Jackass is 49 today.
An online trend right now. It is causing a massive amount of damage in Nebraska. Where kids are running full speed trying to break through neighborhood fences.
No.
These
way.
Wooden ones. They're blasting through them. Apparently, this trend has already cost tens of thousands of dollars. Last week, sheriffs and sheriff's deputies around the Sarpy County of Nebraska have issued many criminal mischief citations to up to 9 kids. Who they saw run and jump into fences in various neighborhoods around the county.
And yell, oh, yeah.
They call it the Kool-Aid Man Challenge. So they're getting a giant running start, and they're trying to blast their way through these wooden fences. At least 8 properties were hit. Several thousand dollars per house in damage. The reason they're catching on to this is people are starting to post the footage from their Ring doorbells, and they see these kids get a whole big running head start. Now, the funny ones are when the kids bounce off. I've seen a couple of these, right? Yeah. When they don't. But when they go through that fence, there's a ton of damage happening.
I blame the parents. I've never hit my child, but he has the fear of God in him. If anything were to happen like this and he got busted for damaging somebody's property because he wanted to be the Kool-Aid man, I can't even tell you.
But we all did stupid things as kids. So here's what I want you to do. I just want you, First Cat, to tell us, as everybody else texts in, what was that dumb kid thing you did?
Probably taking my mom's car out when I was 12. Not just once, but multiple times, thinking I had my license. Like, in my head, I had my license, you know? But I taught myself how to drive a stick shift. I was driving myself to Dairy Queen. I was just, like, driving all over, which is far more dangerous than the Kool-Aid challenge, I think.
My friends and I would lay in these bushes that were right outside my house.
Yeah.
And we'd shoot kids as they rode by on their bikes with our BB guns, and they never knew where it was coming from.
That's horrible.
I mean, we would pelt kids. You know what? I remember this one time. We had to be 10, 11, and these high school kids drove by, and they had one of those Jeeps that didn't have the windows or the doors or anything on it.
Shame on you.
And I pegged this kid in the hip, and they stopped.
Yeah.
And they canvassed the entire neighborhood. They were looking around, and they never found us because we were in this, literally shaking in the bushes.
Doing it to cars, that's horrible.
Oh, we just knew that they would hit this kid because the windows were wide open, and they were just cruising.
Yeah.
And so we used to shoot. Yeah,
don't do any
so
of this.
So stupid. But you were a stupid kid once. Was it stupid as the Kool-Aid challenge?
The Mars and Wrigley Candy Company, they are recalling several varieties of the following gummy candies. So whether it is Skittles gummies, Starburst gummies, and Lifesaver gummies, because customer complaints say that they're finding like metal strands inside their candy.
Just eat it. How's it going to hurt you?
Oh my God. There was a Monsters Inside Me episode, and it was terrible because this guy was cleaning off his grill with a metal brush, throws the steak on there, eats the steak. The metal, just like a little tiny, you wouldn't even be able to see it, got into his system, punctured his intestines, let bile in, He was septic. He was like, I don't know what's going on. And then they find the metal. So
they actually found that little piece of metal in
there.
Yeah, they did. Amazing.
Crazy. All right. So this guy on TikTok, I always think it's so funny. If you like say you're sick, don't post photos of yourself getting a pedicure. You have to be smarter. This guy on TikTok got fired after accidentally friending somebody or answering a friend request on Xbox.
So I got fired from my job today. Don't add random people on Xbox because apparently bosses do that now. And I'm work from home. I play Xbox. You know what I mean?
Oh, my God.
Well, they're probably like, he's not getting his work done. I wonder what he is even doing. Oh, there he is. He's live gaming.
Kat was inspired by Elizabeth Olsen, who is Mary-Kate and Ashley's younger sister. And she was on a lie detector. This is Vanity Fair that does this?
Yeah, they do this. They do the 74 questions with celebrities, so you get to kind of know them on a different level. I thought it was
funny.
And
she got caught lying.
Yep. Danielle was recently in Licorice Pizza. Do you think you're a better actor than her?
Yeah. Sorry, Danielle. I hope she'd agree.
Did you see Licorice Pizza?
I did.
And you didn't think she was very good?
No, I loved the film, and I thought she was great in it. But she didn't have to do much.
She's lying about the film.
What do you mean?
Lying.
About what, liking lying. The film?
That's correct.
They got a professional lie detector guy. He's
and
reading
she's very
it.
Funny, too. So you got to watch it.
So based on that, we decided to play Two Truths and a Lie. Kat will give you three statements. You have to find out which one is the lie. Statement number one.
Is I found out that I was allergic to frogs this weekend.
Number two.
I saw two giant shaky things on the DJ table at Hunk's this weekend.
Number three.
I fell on my way into work today.
One of those is a lie. Chrissy, you're first through. Which one's a lie?
Found out she was allergic to frogs.
That is it. Why would I ever go near a frog? So good job.
Right. That's what I was thinking.
Now,
but I did fall on my way into work today.
How do you fall? It's dry out.
I have these flip-flops on, and they're a little bit too long in the front, and it caught the lip.
God, I wish it was there.
I know. I got up and looked around, and I was the only one existing in that area, and I was like, oh, my God, so embarrassed.
Well, if there's a good thing about walking into work at, like, 4 o'clock in the morning, it's that usually nobody sees anything that's going on.
So weird.
Weird stuff.
Everybody called me weird. I am weird.
You don't think this is a little weird?
No, I don't think it's weird at all.
Weird.
When I was watching this video, I was like, oh my God, I heard this scenario at one point in my life.
So I fly a lot and I like planes. I was on a plane the other day and I was wondering, are there keys to the plane? Do they need keys to start the plane? Maybe that's what those delays on the ground are sometimes. You're just sitting there at the gate. Maybe the pilot's just up there in the cockpit going, oh, I don't believe this.
It happened. I was watching a video and you can too. It's online. A Delta pilot, they had to like jury-rig this conveyor belt and he was climbing out of the window. The pilot window.
The extra door unlocked after 9/11. They put those security doors on there.
I don't know what happened, but I mean, everybody is like nose up against the window filming this poor pilot trying to get out of the window, crawling through. And then he forgot something. So he had to go back in and then come back out. I was like, oh my God, this poor guy.
The Playhouse Podcast is made possible thanks to Bradshaw and Brian Law Offices. Catch the live show weekdays from 5:30 to 9 on 104.7 KCLD. Now, share this with a friend. We'll be right back.